Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study how to multiply two octal numbers without converting to any another base. We will perform the multiplication the same way that the way we perform multiplication in decimals. Here we will write the given numbers 322 into 35. Now we will multiply these digits, octal digits, by the first digit, that is 5, and then later on we will multiply by 3, all these digits. Now the first multiplication is 5 into 2. 5 into 2 is 10 in decimal, but this is octal multiplication, right? So we need to first convert this decimal, that is 10 decimal, to octal. Then how to convert 10 decimal to octal? We know we have to divide the decimal number successively by 8 and write down the remainder aside. So here the quotient is 1, remainder is 2, and when you divide this 1, you will get quotient 0 and remainder as 1 as this. Therefore we can say that 10 decimal is equals to 12 in octal. Out of this 12, 12, we will write 2 here, and carry will be given to the next calculation. Now we will multiply this 5 with this 2. 5 into 2 is 10. 10 plus 1 is 11. Convert 11 into octal. How do you convert 11 into octal? So it is, this is 1, remainder is 3. If you divide this 8 by 1, your quotient is 0, your remainder is 1 as it is. So it is 11 decimal is equals to 13 in octal. This way we can convert any decimal number to octal. Now our result is 13. Out of this result, we'll write 3 here and carry will be going to the next step for further calculation. Now we'll multiply 5 and 3. 5, 3 is a 15 plus 1, 16. When you convert 16 octal to decimal, you will get 20 in octal. So quotient is 2, remainder is 0, and for next calculation your quotient becomes 0 and this remainder is 2 as it is. So this way we will get 16 decimal is equals to 20 octal. Okay, like this we will solve, right? So at last we will write here 20 as it is, because there are no further digits for multiplication. It means when you multiply by all these digits by 5, you will get this 2032. Now to solve the next digit calculation, we will multiply 3 by 2, 3 2s are 6, and 6 is valid octal digit. What are the valid octal digits? 0 to 7 are valid digits. If there are invalid digits, we have to convert that invalid digits to octal, and then we will use it into the calculation. Right now we do not have to convert this 6 into octal, because it is already in octal number system, valid digit. Okay. Now we multiply this 3 with this 2, 3 2s are 6 again, it is also valid. There is no problem, no need to convert it into octal. Now when you multiply 3 by 3, 3 3s are 9. Now 9 is not a valid octal digit, you have to convert it into octal. So when you convert 9 decimal to octal, you will get quotient here 1, remainder as 1. For the next calculation, your quotient becomes 0, remainder 1 as it is, and when you arrange it, you will get 9 in decimal is equals to 11 in octal. So we'll use this 11 here and we'll add all this. Now to get the addition, we're going to use the octal addition rule without converting to any other base. We already studied how to add two octal numbers without converting to any another base in my previous video. If you add this two digits now, 2 plus 0, this cross is 0, 2 plus 0 is 2, and it is already a valid octal digit, there is no need to convert it into any other octal number. Now if we add these two digits, 6 plus 3, 6 plus 3 is 9. Now if you see, 9 is invalid octal digit. Whenever the addition of two digits exceed the last valid number for this octal number system, what are the valid numbers for this octal number system? This is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 is the last valid digit, right? So this 9 is exceeding this 7. So whenever your summation exceeds the last valid digits, last valid digit, you have to generate a carry into the next step. So here one will be carry will be generated. 1 plus 0 plus 6. Total is 7. 7 is already valid, so there is no problem. So you can write here 7. 2 plus 1 is 3. It is also valid. There is no problem. Now this one as it is into the final answer. Now if you check this final answer, there are certain digits which are invalid for this octal number system. Then what to do for with those invalid digits? Now if you see here, 1, 3, 7, and 2 are valid digits. There is no problem with the answer, but there is a problem with a digit 9. 9 is invalid octal digit. We have to subtract the base of the system, that is 8, from the invalid digits only from the result. So we subtract 8 from this 9 to get our actual answer. So what is the actual answer? It is 1, 3, 7. Now 9 minus 8 is 1, and this 2 as it is. So if you see, your answer is 1, 3, 7, 1, 2 in octal. So we can write into our final answer, that is 3, 2, 2 octal into 3, 5 octal is equals to 1, 3, 7, 1, 2 in octal. So this is your result for this multiplication. To understand octal multiplication very well, we'll see one more example to multiply two octal numbers. Now in this second example, we are going to multiply 4, 1, 2 in octal with 4 and 5 in octal. To quickly solve this octal multiplication directly without converting to any another base, we can create, or you can create your multiplication table, octal multiplication table, like this. That the way I have created, you can also create your own octal multiplication table. So here we'll write all the valid digits 0 to 7 in rows as well as in column side. So 0 to 7 here and 0 to 7 here. Now if you multiply with this, how to generate this multiplication table, I'm telling you. When you multiply all these digits by 0, you'll get 0 0 0 0 here, right? So when you multiply all these digits by 1, you'll get all 0 to 7. In this two multiplication, there is no problem of converting this decimal number to octal number. But in next multiplication line, you'll see when you multiply all these digits by 2, you'll get 0, 2, 4, 6. Till now, there is no problem, right? Now, if you see here, 2 fours are 8. 2 fours are 8. Now, 8 in octal is 1, 0. We have not written here 8, it is 1, 0. 2 into 5 is 10, 10 in octal is 12. This way, we have to convert all the decimal numbers to octal. So, 2 5s are 10, but actual answer is in octal is 12. 2 6s are 12, but in octal it is 14. 2 7s are 14, but in octal it is 1 6 16, right? Similarly, you can generate the further rules. Okay, so I have prepared this multiplication table to quickly solve this second problem. Okay, now we'll see this multiplication where we are going to multiply 4 1 2 into 4 5. I am going to use this multiplication table. What is 2 into 5? 2 into 5 is 10, 10 in octal is 12, right? So I will put 2 here and carry 1 will be generated. I will multiply 5 with 1. 5 ones are 5. 5 plus 1 is 6. There is no problem into this. We can directly write. 5 fours are 20. Here 5 fours are 20. But in octal it is 24. So we will write 2 4. Because there are no further digits for calculation. So this is the answer for multiplication of 5 with all these digits. Put a cross here and you multiply now 4 and other digits. 4 with 2, multiply 4 and 2, it is 8. 4 in 2 it is 8, but actual in octal it is, when you multiply 4 into 2 it is 8, 8 in octal is 10, that is 10, we will put 0 here and carry 1 will be generated here. Now you multiply 4 by 1, 4 ones are 4 plus 1, it is 5. Now we will multiply this 4 with this 4, 4 fours are 16. But if you see in the multiplication table, 4 fours are 16, but its equivalent in octal is 20. Okay, so we'll write 20 here, and at last we'll add these two numbers with the octal addition rule, direct addition rule. This 2 plus 0 is 2, 6 plus 0 is 6, and these are also in the octal range, valid range, 0 to 7, so there is no problem, no need to generate a carry. Now if you add these two, now 4 plus 5 is 9, you write 9 here and generate one carry, because this 9 is invalid octal number which is exceeding the last valid digit, that is 7 of this octal number system. Okay, so we generate a carry only when the sum exceed the last valid digit of the octal number system. Now we add this, 2 plus 1 is 3, and this 2 add as it is, all these digits are in valid octal digits, right? Now if you see this answer, there is only one invalid digit in the final answer. If there is any invalid digit in the final answer, you have to subtract the base of the number system, that is 8, from each invalid digit. So we have only one, so we'll subtract this 8 from this 9 and we'll write our final answer, that is 6, 2, 6, 9 minus 8 is 1, this is 3, or this is 2. So therefore we can say that 4, 1, 2 in octal into 4, 5 octal is equals to 2, 3, 1, 6, 2 in octal. So this way we can multiply any two octal numbers directly without converting to any another base. So in this problem we have multiplied these two numbers. This is the answer.